So next we are going to see is about Huygens principle. Okay, so what is this Huygens principle? Is Huygens principle is a geometrical construction which gives the shape of the wavefront even at time t is equal to zero. According to Huygens principle, each point on the wavefront is a source of secondary wavelet. So this is a first point which you have to know, that is if you consider this to be the wavefront and each point on the wavefront, so idhula irukkira ovvoru pointum it acts as a source, so that from this it forms a secondary wavelets. Okay, so each point on the wavefront, so if this is a wavefront, each point on the wavefront it acts as a source, so that it forms with a secondary wavelets, okay, emanating from these points, and it's spreading out with all the directions with the speed of waves, and it spreads out in all the direction, and that spreads with the speed of wave, and these are called as a secondary wavelet. So wavelet which is formed now, that are called as a secondary wavelet. So this is a main thing in the Huygens principle. Okay, so each point on the wavefront, it acts as a source of secondary wavelet, and that moves with the speed of what? Speed of the wave, and these are called as a secondary wavelets. And the common tangent, in other words, the envelope to all this wavelets gives the position and the shape of new wavefront. So when you draw any tangent to this, that gives a position and also a new wavefront. Clear? This is the statement of Huygens principle. Then the propagation of spherical and the plane wavefront is explained during this in this principle. Let AB be the plane wavefront at the time t is equal to zero. So we are considering a plane wavefront, and according to Huygens principle, every point on the AB, it acts as a source of what? Secondary wavelets, and speeds with the speed of wave. To find the position of the wavelets, we are using the circles of radius which are equal to CT. Okay, so at each point we are considering the circles, and it has a radius which is equal to what? C into T. Okay, and the points let us consider as P, Q and R as the centers on AB. So this is A and B, and the tangent or the forward envelope A dash B dash. So from this we are having a forward envelope, and that forward envelope is named as A dash and B dash. Okay, and this A dash B dash will be a spherical wavefront, and this is considered to be a spherical wavefront. Okay, and first one is a plane wavefront, and if you are placing at a large distance, that is at a infinity. Okay, here we have the diagram. So from this point source we get with this wavefront. So each wavefront acts as a source, so we are considering the circles. From the circles we get this. Okay, and this is a spherical wavefront. Okay, and here is a plane wavefront, so which are represented in a straight line like this. Okay, next we have proof for laws of reflection using the Huygens principle. We are going to prove with the law of reflection. Let us consider a parallel beam of light, and it which is incident on the reflecting surface. So this is a reflecting surface, this is a parallel beam of light, and this is incident on the plane mirror xy. The incident wavefront is AB. Okay, so the incident wavefront we are writing as AB, and the reflected wavefront is A dash B dash. Here is a reflected wavefront which are named as A dash and B dash. Okay, and these wavefronts are perpendicular to the incident rays L and M. Okay, so these are the incident rays AB, and these are the reflected rays A dash B dash. So any ray from the point L, it reaches the surface at A, then from here it gets reflected. Same way from M, it reaches at the point B dash, then again it is getting reflected towards M dash. Okay, the point A of the incident wavefront touches the reflecting surface. So from here, as it touches this reflecting surface, the point from B travels the distance B B dash. Okay, travels the distance B B dash and touches the surface at the point B dash. Okay, when the point from B falls on the surface B dash, A have reached A dash, okay? So by the time it reaches from here to here, this A also reaches a point A dash, okay? And this is applicable to all the wavefront. Thus, the reflected wavefront A dash B dash emanates as a plane wavefront. So this reflected wavefront is as a plane wavefront because it is as a straight line. So it is considered to be a plane wavefront, okay? The two normals N N dash, okay? So these are the normals, which are normals N and N dash, and they are considered at all the points where L and M fall on the reflecting surface. So L and M, it is falling on the reflecting surface. At this point, the normals are drawn, okay? As the reflection happens in the same medium, the speed of light is the same before and after reflection, okay? Speed of light will be the same since we are considering with the same medium. The time taken from B to B dash is the same from A to A dash, and so we can say that the distance B B dash is also equal to A A dash. So A A dash is equal to B B dash, okay? Since the time is same and also it say has the same medium, we can say the distances are same, okay? So according to the laws of reflection, the incident ray, reflected ray and the normal, they are in the same plane. So all are in the same plane. Angle of incidence, which is given by N A L, okay? So that N A L can be written as this angle, which is 90 degree, and this angle, which is B, and this is A, and this is B dash, okay? And here we have the angle N, okay? So this angle NAB, okay? So this half the angle can be written as this full angle minus this angle, is it not? So this full angle is what? 90 minus this angle is what? Which is, this is NAL, okay? And here we are writing as this is L, this is N, this is A, and this is B, okay? NAL can be written as 90 minus NAB, okay? So how we are writing this? Again, I'm saying this, here is N and here is A and here is L, and same way here we have with B. So how to write with this angle is this full angle minus of this angle. So this NAL can be written as, so what is this full angle is 90 degree minus this angle, which is NAB, okay? So it is NAB. So 90 minus this NAB can be written as BA B dash, because we know this full angle, which is NA B dash, okay? And here we have BA B dash, okay? So 90 minus this, so 90 minus this angle can be written as this one. So it is BAB dash. Yes, clear with this? Same way when you are writing for laws of reflection, this is for incidence. Same way when you are writing for the next one, reflection, okay? That reflection, we are going to consider N dash, B dash, M dash, okay? So N dash, B dash, M dash. So this angle is what? R, which is the reflection, okay? And so this can be written as, taking with the next side, okay, this one, this is A dash, this angle is what? 90 degree. Same way, 90 minus N dash B dash, so this angle, which is N dash B dash and A dash, okay? So that gives you the N dash, A dash and B dash, okay? This can also be written as this, considering with the next triangle. So next triangle we are considering is A, B dash, A dash, and here we have with N, okay? So this full angle is 90. So 90 minus this angle can be written as this one. So it is A dash, B dash, A, okay? And so here we have with B A B dash, and here we are having with A dash B dash A. So angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection, since both this angle are equal. okay? So that is what has been proved in this. Since the two triangles A, B, B dash, and also the next triangle is B dash, A dash, and A, that two are right angle triangles. So right angle triangle, one side is equal, okay, and one, this one A dash, A, A dash, and B, B dash are equal, and A, B is common. And so we can say that the two triangles are equal. Since the two triangles are equal, we can say the angles are also equal. So I is equal to R. This proves with the laws of reflection. Okay. Thank you.